Hello there. I want to be the first to talk to her. I'm just kidding.
I'm back.
Okay, so Ray's admittedly a geeky girl. She likes a lot of interest from video games and also Star Wars and stuff now like Marvel movies. So, I mean, you probably don't consume as much comic book media as we do. I know you consume more manga. So, you've had a great time catching up with Marvel movies.
Yeah, just recently. There's been quite a lot I have to catch up, but I was guided to which movies to watch. As Richard said, I am a geek, but more towards the Eastern and manga anime side of things. But that doesn't stop me from also exploring the Western pop culture media and content.
And there's certainly actually a very large universe of comic book Western pop culture media. I mean, as we've talked about it, there's now so many TV, television series being put out there. And having now dipped your foot and even plunged into it, what do you feel as the state of the comic book inspired in movies and television? I mean, for you, as a newer consumer,
How do I feel about the whole Marvel Western superheroes? What was your question again?
Okay, so you've just basically, me, Alan, Sanjeev, we've really stepped into this. We've been into this comic book stuff for decades already. So we've actually seen characters that we've read as younger people, younger men, in comic books, and now they've reinterpreted into the movies in various editions. I mean, there's so many editions of Batman that Sanjeev knows, and not all of them are good. That aside, because I think you as maybe a fresh person into this line, you don't carry the baggage that we do and expectations, right?
Yeah, that's right.
So as someone who is perhaps not originally a fan of the titular superheroes, except for Iron Man that your father enjoyed, how do you feel stepping into this universe and grappling with all that information coming in?
Okay, as Richard said, I am a newcomer to the whole MCU side of things, and of course, I do know the characters, but I do not know in detail because I did not actually grow up with the comics. But it was the movies that introduced me to all of these characters, and it not only introduced me, but it opened up to the entire world as well. Now, a very good example is I was in Japan very recently in the geek haven of Akihabara, and I did notice that there are a lot of young people over there wearing apparel and carrying merchandises that says Marvel on it. So I believe the movies actually opened up a lot, opened up to mainstream, and it's a great way to introduce these characters that has been around since my dad's time. I was introduced to Marvel through my dad. I mean, he loves characters like Iron Man. He even had his business card saying, can I call myself Dr. Strange because I'm a doctor?
Yeah?
So I believe that with the movies, for those who do not know the comics and are just getting to know about Marvel, I believe you should just put your foot in it. The movies, they're really fun. Everyone can enjoy it. And yeah, welcome to the club.
Oh yeah, so I think you coined it pretty well. Everyone can enjoy it, right? And that's not necessarily the problem with some of the productions out there in the dark ages. Not some of those Yeah, okay, 1990 Captain America. A Fantastic Four, which was made in 1994, was so bad it wasn't even released.
Oh man, yeah, that
not one. Everyone can enjoy those. But now, everyone can. And who in the world would not now know now who is the Avengers?
Oh yeah, I think accessibility, that's the word, yeah.
Of course, it has the corporate muscle behind it of Disney. And the Mouse House, I think, does a great job of pushing it out everywhere.
Yeah.
Okay, we are kind of like running out of time, so I mean, I just like to conclude with perhaps how do you feel the direction of what we have as comic book superhero movies in the next 10 years? What do you think we'll be seeing? Of course, without reference to what's next in the MCU, that would be spoilery because Avengers Endgame, not everyone has watched it, but what do you expect in the comic book, superhero, film and television landscape? Sanjeev?
Yeah, thanks Richard. Myself, I believe what would continue happening would be a lot more films in the Marvel Cinematic Universe, because that has turned out to be a cash cow for Disney, at least, you know, it's their biggest franchise at the moment and to date. So it'll just continue until it gets to a point that there's massive oversaturation, and they'll go quiet for a while, or they would do soft reboots of sorts, right? So I might sound very like cynical and like, you know, like making fun of the whole idea of what they are doing, but I'm the guy that's like dressed up on stage as a character.
Yeah.
So I think at the end of the day, I mean, it's not so much a love-hate relationship, it's just a love-love relationship. They've normalized what we do. But at the same time, I think as a fan and speaking for our collective fandom as well, you know, too much of a good thing isn't a good thing. That's my take on it.
Yeah, but man, I mean, I think there was one era where sci-fi was the in thing in cinema. And I think this was around the late 90s or something like that. And even the in thing in television. Mm-hmm. And some of them were really bad. Okay, Alan, the next 10 years.
Throw up a few. Sliders, though.
Yeah, no, Sliders was actually quite good. They lasted quite long. But I mean, there were bad ones. You see, they're so bad, I don't remember them.
Okay.
Yeah, Alan, the next 10 years.
Talk about muscle, right? Now the muscle, the Mouse House, has just acquired back the rights for the X-Men, the Mutants, and Fantastic Four. Oh man. Yeah, if I'm gonna take on what Sanjeev said, prediction. I think it would be a good idea to let this MCU and the Avengers rest. Well, they start to do the... I don't think so, but...
It's not going to happen, Alan. It's not. I have foreseen it.
You know, start X-Men, start Fantastic Four, and then bring back the Avengers, yeah, or sorts. Maybe, yeah. So, yeah, stand here as well.
Well, to say, Deadpool is under Disney now.
Yes.
One of the funniest things would actually be see Deadpool cameo in every Marvel movie like Stan Lee.
Oh, he takes over the banner. I thought you were going to say Disneyland, so Deadpool's at every Disneyland. Now that's something.
Craig, Ray, what would you expect in the next, or what would you like to see in the next 10 years of superhero-inspired film and TV?
Personally, I believe that as long as, you know, we all love superheroes for a reason. They are larger than life, they inspire us, and every child is a look up to their dads as superheroes. So as long as that spark is there, as long as that love, that fascination is there, you'll always see more and more superheroes. You'll see a slew of superhero movies coming up in the next 10 years. And personally, I do agree with Alan. I do want to see the X-Men. Well, X-Men coming up. Yes. And this time I would like to come in at the right time, understanding that now there's this trend where they release, like, take a look at Marvel, for instance, it's been 10 years and all the movies are of each hero related to one another. So this time, personally, I would like to get in on the first movie and follow it all the way up to the 10, 13 or 20. So like, yeah, it's a whole culture, I believe, in terms of appreciating pop culture. It's not something that it's something that I'm actually looking forward to.
Alright, with that, I think it's time to conclude our panel. you very much for your opinions, Sanjeev, Alan, and Ray.
Thanks, Richard.
Enjoy Avengers Assemble.
For the nth time, right? For the many nth time.
That's right, Excelsior.
How many times have you watched it?
Right, Excelsior.
Endgame, how many times have you watched it? Only once. Alan, does it?
Yeah, only once so far.
Richard?
But I'd like to say the guys here can take this opportunity to watch Avengers Endgame again, free tonight, with compliments of TGV. So go somewhere, there's somewhere you can redeem the tickets.
This is not a spoiler of the movie, but it's actually a fact. Endgame was shot on digital IMAX. So if you really want to watch Avengers Endgame in the format in which it was shot in, you have to watch it in digital IMAX, which is here at, you know, Velocity, one of the digital IMAX here, IMAX Hall, yeah. So yeah, do check it out here.
Okay, thank you very much for listening to this yabber. So look forward to hearing from you.
Throwing out some spoilers now, though.
No spoilers. Well, okay, thank you all.
Thanks.
Good night.
May the force be with you all.
Long and prosper.
Peace and long life.
Excelsior.
Alright, yes, thank you. One member of the panel is Richard, Sanjeev, Alan, beautiful lady as well. Thank you so much for your opinions. I actually found that very interesting and very knowledgeable for myself at least, because I believe all of us, like it or not, we started off with Iron Man. Yes, because we were not in their era, so all of us started off from Iron Man, and ever since Iron Man came out, we have followed all the Marvel movies. So getting insights from these experts really let us know what we can see in the coming future. So that's very important for us, and I'm really excited to see how will Marvel take Endgame towards the next step. So ladies and gentlemen, for those of you guys who have yet to watch Avengers Endgame, you do have an opportunity today. Alright, later at 9 o'clock, we do have a screening.